Oakland is the 8th largest city in California and sits 8 miles east of San Francisco across the San Francisco Bay. East Oakland is home to some of the most notoriously violent streets in California. Up until the 1970s, most of East Oakland was suburban and middle class. But many of the industrial jobs in the area disappeared, causing rapid socioeconomic decay. For this reason, many parts of East Oakland became plagued with high crime, drugs, and homicide in the decades to follow. I met Dame Hooker back in 2006. Dame has seen a lot of violence most people would only see in a Hollywood movie.
I'm Dame Hooker, aka Hooker Boy. I was raised in North Oakland and East Oakland. I'm 35, so I've been out here for at least 22 years roaming the streets of Oakland. In those 22 years, I lost over like 30 of my closest friends through gun violence.
Gun violence, like sideshows, is just a part of daily life.
Sideshow is Oakland, you feel me? Oakland is the sideshow, you feel me? So you know what I'm saying? Basically what you're about to see right here is how we get down into town. The sideshow, man, it started like in 86, you feel me? East Oakland, the main strip was 68 from Foothill, you feel me?
Man, the sideshow, it goes down in the sideshow. Everything goes down. We stop in the middle of the street. Can't nobody touch us. The police, nobody. They trying to stop us, but we just go around the block, hit the block, do the same thing. Nothing. Turn everything out everywhere we go.
Basically, with the trunk, open the hood, open the doors, open.
Hanging out the door. Door open, man. This is the sideshow, man. This is the sideshow.
Officer Jason Scott of the Oakland Police Department, Traffic Enforcement Division. Basically, sideshow activity is people gathering, large groups gathering, you know, with cars to take part in reckless driving, you know, exhibitions of speed, spinning donuts. A lot of times they'll take over parking lots, take over intersections.
The sideshow, man, original, man, we ain't running for 5-0. We ain't running, we just doing what we do best.
A lot of people kind of put it off for a lack of things to do in the community.
We ain't got shit to do out here at Oakland. Man, ain't shit to do. What you gonna do?
But a lot of this stuff happens after those hours. So, you know, 2-3 o'clock in the morning, you know, you're looking for a place to gather up. That's what kind of causes it. But I was told that sideshows have actually been around for a long time. You know, in the past, the sideshow didn't include a lot of the violence and things. They said it's kind of like, you know, a car show, basically out there on the weekends. You know, people just basically showing out, hanging out, you know, guys wanting to talk to girls and show their cars off, that type of thing. But, you know, in the city of Oakland, unfortunately, that's not the type of activity we're trying to have, you know, late night in our city streets. Much rather put the money into, you know, creating a venue that they do have something to do instead of paying officers to go out here and kind of, you know, regulate sideshow activity.
You know what I'm talking about? It's town business, man. That's how we do it. Bay life. That's how it is, man.
At the time this story on the sideshow was filmed, gun violence and homicides were spiking in many parts of Oakland. The city recorded 116 homicides in 2008. Making it the third highest total in California. I reunite with Dame to speak about the violence he's experienced in the streets. He has not only witnessed the destruction caused by gun violence, but Dame has also been shot 4 times in the past and survived. Many of his peers have been shot as well.
East Oakland, California, you feel me? Right here on 76 and MacArthur Boulevard. It's the terror zone right now, you feel me? I live in the killing fields, that's how I look at it. I ain't gotta go to Beirut to know about war, you feel me?
My name is Dr. Andre Campbell. I am a trauma surgeon at San Francisco General Hospital. I am right in the midst of what is, I think, an epidemic of violent crime in the African-American community. I could tell you that from what I see, people, young people, are being shot for things that are just, in my mind, totally ridiculous.
So my name is Dame Hooker. I'm Oakland, California. Well, I got shot like two times, two different occasions, one in 94 and one in 99. One in 94, I got got into an altercation over a car. Came up, wop, tried to take me and my partner out. Hit me one time in my leg, you feel me? I survived that one.
Like I said, I done been through it out here, man. I ain't been shot once, but I done been shot like on two different occasions. And when I say out here, I ain't gotta go too far, man. I done been shot right up there on top of that hill right there. And I done been shot right around the corner on 77, you feel me?
What has happened is that instead of sitting down and discussing things, people deal with beefs or disputes by settling it with a weapon instead of sitting down and having conversation.
Well, the first time I got shot, I pulled up in front of the stove and grabbed some switches at the stove. And when I came out the stove, some motherfuckers tried to assassinate my character by coming around the corner and sneak attacking me, and I seen this lightweight jumping off, so you know, went down the way it had to go down, you feel me? I wound up getting clipped, you know what I'm saying?
I've been a doctor now for 22 years. From what I could see now is that people are being shot by a higher caliber weapon.
Oh, I got hit with a Mag 90 and a 40 cal. The second time I got shot, and I got shot at with a cater before I got hit in my elbow.
It's like equivalent of having a bomb go off inside of your abdomen, inside of your chest, inside of your leg, and causes just absolute devastation to the human body no matter where you're hit.
I've been hit in the stomach, my back, legs. I got bullets in my stomach, my back. I got all kind of shit going on. I got big wounds, boy. When I say big wounds, nigga. Chopper shit, you feel me? Chopper city, boy.
I was in East Oakland at my baby mama house. Some cats trying to rob me. He tussling for the pistol. He squeezed the trigger, and that's when he hit me right here. Nick, right here in my chest. And you can see it didn't go all the way through right there. He bust the whole clip on me, though, the police said. He only hit me like four times. Went to this dude's house. I called 911. The answer machine came on like six times. They said I flatlined one time. They brought me back. But I don't remember none of that. So everybody be talking about, oh, I seen a light. I think I died. You don't remember none of that. You don't remember none of that.
This my nigga T1, you feel me? The one and only, you know what I'm talking about?
Advantage, no.
Straight up. My nigga done been cooked, you know what I'm saying, fried right there on Nate Street, 73rd, you know what I'm saying? This man done been hit with an AK-47, mate, on his own time, you feel me?
Take a nigga out, man, you know how we do it. A little war wound, you know, this shit ain't nothing, no, you know, it's nothing, man.
It ain't easy being a bandit, man, I'm gonna tell you that right now. Youngsters out here not really having nothing to do when they don't have nowhere to direct their energy or nothing like that. That's all you got, man. You don't have no money. Your moms and pops, they dope fiends and shit. You know what I'm saying? You got to get out here and spend for yourself at a young age and try to make it happen.
It is a devastating problem that we're trying to confront here with this, what I think is a genocide in our community where large numbers of African Americans are being killed. I mean, we talk about Darfur and things being terrible there, but here we have the similar kind of thing going on.
It's real out here, though. It's a lot of murders. A lot of people getting killed. And I'm one of the survivors, though. You know what I'm saying? My little cousin, he wasn't a survivor. He got shot like one time in the kidney. It was over. One time in the kidney. 17 years old. It's a cold game out here, man.
But it is what it is, you know. I'm out here living, man. We on 76, we represented to the fullest, man. You know? 76 is main. It's my brothers, you know what I'm saying? The Cutters. Hey, your boy act up and I'm right now, man, we in East Oakland, California. For y'all that don't know, East Oakland, California.
So what? Your name Hennessy?
Yeah, my name is Hennessy. I got the purple and white interior popping off.
I want you to show me your Oakland, man.
All that, man. I'm finna get on these little thin ass legs, man, and we're gonna push Philly through tight. The city. You feel me? Philly. Phase 3, the studio. Yeah, man, I'm up in this mother. You feel me? I'm finna go ahead and grease this microphone. I ain't talking about just with spit, I'm talking about with licks and shit. Pull out this heavy artillery I got and gas this thing, so. I ain't never been jumped, I ain't never been punked, I ain't never been stumped. My name is known to get down on the microphone. I run up in your home, take everything you own. Y'all look out for the CDs and shit.
Where we at, Hennessy?
Right here in Oakland still. You gotta slide through the ghetto, through the back streets, dog. You know what I'm talking about? Keep it pushing, man.
What are we doing? What's going on?
We just pulled up at the gas station, you feel me? This is about one of the most popular gas stations in Oakland. Broad daylight, man. No telling what the fuck you might see out here.
We're getting hypey in here right now.
Hey! It's my nigga Pretty Black, man. This nigga is so motherfucking clean.
All right, nah, we fuck with right here. MOE, money over everything. Young nigga getting money. That's
European wet fat. Hey, what's up,
Henry? Black ass nigga.
Hey, this is my brother from another mother right here, man. He in that purple thing, man. I'm getting on his new album. He getting on my album.
I'm thinking about moving here.
Hey.
Come on home.
Hey, you good?
Come on home.
You got your, hey, you with this nigga, you got a lifetime pass, man.
Anyway, man, you know, like I said, man, I fall back like a soldier supposed to. I kicks with my man JT, my nigga Black, you know what I'm saying? We just doing what we do. Man, my everyday living, man, life. Niggas I fuck with, man, how I get down, man, this is it. East Southern California, you seen what we call town business, for real.
Luxury Learjets, imagine the places I've been. I pushed up Sunset Ave, 125th, or was it MLK?
What's been going on since we last talked to you? About like 20 more murders. A lot of murders out here, a lot of killings, man. Senseless murders.
Up here, we gonna put the camera down.
Put it like down low for niggas to think that motherfucker gun. We're gonna put it down, cut it off.
Go that way. Fuck no. That's the road. That's not the block to go that way.
I wish you could be with me 24 hours a day. You'll see some real shit when the sun go down. Hey, oh, what the fuck was that, dude? You're like, what the hell? Was that a gunshot or an army?
This is what I got for.
Sin, what
did
I do with that razor?
Sin, you got some lotion?
Hey, Dame. Why are the burners on?
Burners on to keep the heat. This the ghetto. This right here is the heater. This is called the heater. Ghetto heat. It's cold in here. I'm in West Oakland.
That's your computer?
Yeah.
What do you do with it?
I do a lot of editing on here. No, mostly on this computer, I do graphics. Graphic designs. Flyers, posters. Parties, weddings, funerals. You do it all, man. Time to go. To the streets. Welcome to West Oakland, man. Let me take you on a tour right quick.
The streets are often to blame for all the crime and violence, but the streets don't have a face. So we set out on a journey to find out just what makes the streets such a dangerous place. This time around, we find many people with a story to tell.
Yeah! Stop the beast of the bank.
It's the USA. Man, my name is Shampoo. I was like 19 when I got popped. I'm a paraplegic from the waist down. But I got my head on my shoulders. I'm a good person, you feel me? And I'm still breathing, man. I'm still here. It's a hard knock life in West Oakland, California, man. It ain't a game out here.
Allie Al, you feel me? Over here, my hood, born and raised, 77 Greenside. It's East Oakland. People get killed every day.
Shoot, East Oakland, recording artist, rapper. I've been here my whole life. It ain't no stopping. Ain't no order. Ain't no structure.
What it is, you know, a lot of crack babies out here, man. A lot of our parents was on crack. Now them kids is now 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 25, and they having babies. So now babies are crack babies out here. Now they killing each other like it's a football game.
Man, I lost 20 partners. I'm 35 years old. The change is not for the better, straight for the worse.
Like right now, niggas just get killed for nothing. They running around, so ain't nobody getting no money.
But the game changed when all the older blacks gave up on the younger blacks, man, and that's gave them off to the society to eat like dogs, man.
The change is not for the better, straight for the worse.
Black man on black man, it's just some real shit. It's been happening since the 70s, and it's gonna happen till they cut the lights out on this small-time planet. If the youngsters is watching, think before you react. Because 9 times out of 10, you're gonna do the rest of your life in prison. But if not, them gangsters might come back and get you. Black man on black man, it's just some real shit. It's been happening since the 70s, and it's gonna happen till they cut the lights out on this small-time planet.
You know what I'm saying? I done lost 150 motherfuckers in 27 years. Some motherfuckers get killed for following other motherfuckers. Some motherfuckers get killed wrong place, wrong time. Some motherfuckers get killed for doing things that they knew they wasn't supposed to do. So it's normal to us.
Loose cannons, man. Loose cannons, that's all. That's all, motherfuckers, you feel me? I ain't funkin' for the right reason, motherfuckers. That's how I look at it. I mean, everybody entitled to their own opinion. And my opinion is, you feel me, motherfuckers just do shit because the next nigga, you feel me, trying to impress the next nigga. If everybody be their own man, just mind their business, and all get on the same money height, it'd be good, straight up. Senseless, really.
All this shit is part of life. It's just our reality is a little bit faster than the next man's, you know what I'm saying?
You know, it's bad. You know, ain't nothing we can really do about it. You know, it's going on everywhere, from Jamaica to London to everywhere. It just so happened we in Oakland.
Gun violence is nothing new to the many families of East Oakland. We run into Bobby Hall, whose brother was gunned down in front of his home in the early 90s. A mural was put up in his honor that still stands today.
Y'all see it in front of my brother mural, man. Plan B, Jesse Raheem Hall, man. My brother died from a gunshot, mistaken identity. This been up here for 15 years, and it was just about the respect he had, the things he did for people, the love he got, you know? So that's what make it like a monument for Oakland. We still don't know who did it. To this day, it's 2008, and we still looking. I got shot riding with the wrong person, man. I was 24. I'm happy to be alive. I'm happy to be walking. The bullet's still in my back. It's an inch away from my spine, you know? I just made 25 last year. I'm finna be 26 this year. I'm trying my best, like, to stay out the way, man. That's why the murder rate it is why it is, because can't nobody respect nobody. Respect everybody like you want to be respected, man. Sure. Keep it lit, man.
Love you, bro.
Really, when you're from here and when you grow up here, you go through a stage in your life, you know, 11, 12 years old, where you want to be a part of the streets. You know, you got somebody in your family, your uncle, most likely your daddy or somebody like that is up in the streets. And it's fascinating to you know, you see the cars and the women. I think when you grow up around it, it's a part that you can't help. You can't help it.
Out here, people make money however they can. This can be glamorous and even fascinating, but it can be a very dangerous game. We run into East Oakland rapper Pretty Black a year later.
Black gloves keep a black Glock in my stash box. Feds on my case try and crack me like Madlock. You know what I mean? Y'all caught me last time in my Monday car. You feel me? It's Sunday today. I ain't in the Lamborghini. I'm in my Sunday car. It's the Sunday whip on the 30th. Off top, man. Anybody will tell you that, nigga. I'm really out here every day in these streets, man. You're usually good in the town, but the murder rate in the town is unbelievable. I'm about getting money, man, so my rims is older than me. I just turned 25 2 days ago, man. I'm sitting on 30s, man. So motherfuckers say what they want about me. All black got this nigga looking for him. Well, if you looking for me, nigga, I ain't that hard to find because I'm in the streets every day. So if you run up on this one of these whips, you feel me? Just know you're going to have that 30
30 or better, man. 30 or better with me at all times. Motherfucker don't want to see them hollows, man. Niggas getting money, man.
Hey, let me let y'all get this coat real quick, man. This is a $600 coat, man. Them crystals on the back of the coat, man.
Yeah, that's about a soft 25,000, man, right there, man. That's a soft 50.
I was 70,000 for the Hummer, 15,000 for the rims, and I got a soft 10,000 on me.
Man, don't call me Pretty Black, aka a walking lick for nothing.
Get that, man. Pretty Black, man.
Pretty Black, baby. Hold on, let me get that. Ah, Pretty Black, baby. It's good, man. Love you,
love
bro.
You, bro.
Love
you,
no,
good,
man.
It's good. All right,
bro.
For sure,
bro.
Be easy, bro.
What's up?
We stay out top of the door, you know what I'm talking about? Hey, hey, yo, this prime chow at Hagenburger at Ben's Burger. Let me show you how the kid do it, man. The boy bloody murder in the hood of the 90s, man. The boy never skirt.
When you used to wear this shirt, what do that mean?
Well, oh, this hoodie?
Yeah, like.
Man, it's just. Feel me? He's just showing everybody that he's still here. He's still always gonna be missed. It's hectic out here. Everybody losing niggas every day though.
What y'all doing? Why is y'all going so wild? What's up with the
man? Feel me? I don't know why these other youngsters going wild. They just sick. Feel me? They sick, man. I don't know. Feel me? It ain't really no explanation for it.
You gonna be any different?
Oh no, nah, me. Feel me? I'm calm and collective. We cool until you try to cross me. You cross me, I'ma cross you. Feel me? Know what I'm talking about? Simple as that.
What you been up to since we talked to you last week?
Oh, nothing. Trying to just remain humble, get money, know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Just trying to do me. Just doing me, feel me?
You going to school?
Yeah, I'm on independent studies.
Yeah?
Yeah, I've been to a couple high schools.
Yeah.
And finally decided to do independent studies.
Are you gonna get a diploma?
Oh yeah, most definitely. I need my diploma. I need mine. Feel me? I got siblings and everything. Feel me? We all gotta have something. Feel me? I'm the second oldest. Feel me? I'm my mama's oldest son. So feel me? Gotta make something happen. Feel me?
Right,
that's how I feel.
Hey, little nigga.
Oh, let me shoot. Hey, let me out. Shoot. Oh yeah, let me out.
So do you think it's as easy as choosing not to go towards the street?
No, it's not that easy. Because
can't you just wake up and say, you know what, I'm not gonna do this. I'm just gonna choose to go to school or get a job.
You could, but you gotta be so strong mentally that you gotta be on like almost a genius level. Because you gotta think about it. You could take a black kid and if he's born in China and he gets raised till he's 12 in China, he's gonna speak Chinese. You understand what I'm saying? So if you raised in this environment, your mama and your daddy, you know, they on drugs and you around here and you trying to get outside, you gotta go outside every day and it's all that's around you, your cousins in it. So it's been generations, it's been passed on. So what it becomes is a normalcy. It's normal now. You get what I'm saying? This is nature. You don't know nothing else. You know what I'm saying? So it ain't as easy as choosing for some people, because some people, all they got is the street.
What's up, Hennessy?
How we doing? Just chilling, man.
Yeah?
Just holding it down, man. Everybody just trying to make something happen, man. It's a good day today. Sun's out. Just chilling right now, you feel me? We lost a lot of brothers out here, you know. My partner Earn, y'all seen him in the last one, but he ain't here right now. He got killed, you know what I'm saying? And a few more brothers, you know what I'm saying? Before all this shit, you know what I'm saying? My family come first. So my seeds, you know what I'm saying? Most of all, my kids. Put that out there. I love them to death, you feel me? So that's what all this shit is for. It's for my kids, bro.
It's supposed to be today, right?
You feel me? I get out here every day and bust my ass, man, just to make something happen, you feel me? Just like everybody else. It's only for means to eat, man. Ain't none of this shit just for the glory or for the glitter or just to be happy feet and run right here, all that shit. I do it because I got to, man. I'm surviving, doing what I can, bro. You feel me? These people really don't give a fuck about what's going on out here, you feel me? So like I said, I do what I can, you know what I'm saying? Just trying to stay out the way, bro. Oh yeah, well anyway, yeah, you know, I keep big wheels and toys and all that, you know, the hood, we do what we do best, you know what I'm talking about, so I got a box Chevy that's finna slide up in a minute, on the 26s, you feel me, everything sitting on big rims.
Yeah, there they go, look, turn,
you feel me, you gonna slide through here and see big wheels, boy, 26s, 24s, candy paint, yeah, I'm talking about Pope White, it's a must, man, loud music.
Charge 0 0 photo.
house. Big shit, you feel me? Big engines, big transmissions. I mean, you know, skinny niggas beasted, you hear me? Straight up. Welcome to Bandonville, California, nigga. Big clean ass photos, big rims, big niggas, young niggas with big money. Hey man, it's the slab. But it do go bad though. Don't never forget that shit. Everything that glitter ain't gold. We go through all kind of shit for this shit out here, you feel me? Talking about bullet wounds, nigga, I got all kind of shit. Took me a long time to get back on my feet, dog, but I'm back, you feel me? A lot of motherfuckers ain't gonna come on, but damn near everybody over here got a bullet in their ass.
Yeah. My name Will, man. I got shot up in front of my house right there on 76 and Nate Street, man.
You wanna show some of your bullet wounds?
Oh yeah, got a big hole right here. Damn, I got two bullets in my spine. If they take them out, I'm gonna be paralyzed, you feel me? Mm-hmm. I got shot right before my birthday, 3 weeks before my birthday, before I turned 21. My life was my birthday. That was my birthday present, was my life, you feel me? I take it like that.
Oh, my name's Derek Williams, and I'm 16, and I got shot like 3 years ago, and I got paralyzed. Walking home from school, somebody just started shooting.
At you, or like at
somebody else?
You just happened to get caught?
They be trying to walk around with guns, thinking they hit with guns. Look at me, take a good idea. I've been in this chair too long.
You're still young.
Yeah.
With me raising my son, I realized this. You could keep, a parent could keep their kid from doing anything they want them to do as long as they stay cool to them. Because once the streets become cool to them, they're gonna flock to that. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But if you as a father or a mother, if you could stay cool to your kids and stay in their life, you see what I'm saying? You could have more influence on the decisions they make. I had rap, so I had something else I could channel my mind to. But most of the time, I try and live my life by classy code, you know, like a grown ass man, take care of my kids and do my music and take my ass home and shit. So do rap feed my kids? Nah, not right now. Rap ain't feed my kids yet, but that's why I'm doing things, doing, you know, interviews, songs. Just doing what you gotta do, man. You gotta hustle some way.
California game, nigga. Listen up, bud. Niggas spit it how they lyrics. I live that shit every day on my knees. So forget that shit. I ain't got it. Way out of town.
Like, what's up, man? You tuning in with Dame Dollar. We at the Attic Studios in Oakland, California, man. I'm here with Sosa, Act Up, the other heads of the movement. That's where the movement started, man. That's where we come to stay out of trouble, basically. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Make music. Do positive things, man.
Whatever, it's a feeling, it's an energy here that they can't find nowhere else. And, you know, we don't know what it is. You just put that on God.
It's a family.
You feel me?
It's a family. It's more than the music, you feel me?
We have a lot of people that come through here. So, you know, in the meantime, they here doing music instead of out in the streets getting in trouble and, you know, being in places that they shouldn't be.
A lot of people do a lot of bad things in the street because they don't got a family, because they don't got fathers. So the young people that be coming up here look at us as big brothers and fathers because they ain't got nothing outside in the streets.
Yo, what up, world? You know what I'm saying? It's Mr. Fab, man, holding down right now. The streets are very enticing, man. You know, the streets are some things, man. It's one of those spots and one of those places, man, that's hard to overcome. You know, and it's a hard thing, man, because sometimes the streets is their only outlets, man. The streets is the only thing that embrace them, that show them love, that give them an opportunity to feed their family.
This is Mr. Bathgate right here, West Oakland, California. So, man, I'd have been in the penitentiary to YA. You know what I'm saying? I'd have been shot 10 times, man. When you're selling drugs, when you're in the street, bullets come with it.
Yeah, just kick the snake, man. Find your talent. Find what you do best, man. You know what I mean? Do something productive. Do something positive. I love music. It saved my life. You know what I mean?
It's a blessing, man, having the opportunity to do the things that you love to do, to actually reap the benefits from it, man. Being able to go around the world,
been able to meet people that you've always looked up to?
For me, I changed my life, you know. I was doing my little rap thing. I got signed on No Limit. Yeah, I was doing it big with Master P. We was touring. Snoop Dogg, we was doing overseas tours. I seen a lot of movie stars, met a lot of people, you know. So you can change your life, because I came from the gutter of the streets.
Yeah, tell me how many people you know live their dream, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? I'm motivation. I just want to let them know you can do whatever you want to do. Work hard at what you do. I wasn't always me.
And it actually shows you the possibility of how dreams do come true. A lot of people feel like there is no opportunity out here in these streets and inner cities all around the world, but the opportunity is what you make it. Life is what you make it.
I had to put in a lot of work to get to where I'm at, so I appreciate it all, you know what I mean?
Yeah, music is safe, man. No matter what they talking about, it's still safer than actually being on the street.
And why people are still starving and still doing bad in these streets, it's only gonna continue. But my advice to the youth is to find something that you love to do and that you're involved in and constantly do it and execute it. Look at me. I come from where you come from. Daddy died from AIDS. Mama, a former crackhead, man, cancer patient, man. You feel me? Brother got 400 years in jail. But I ain't letting that hold me back, you feel me? I'm still pushing, man. I'm still every day out here dreaming.
I'm Officer Jeff Thomason with Oakland Police Department. I'm the public information officer. I've been on the force for about 10 years, did 4.5 years in patrol in East Oakland. There is a lot of violent crime, a lot of calls for service that happens in East Oakland, and that's our, and what we consider East Oakland is from High Street all the way to the San Leandro border. And what I've seen being out there on patrol is that you have a lot of younger kids out there running around committing crimes and also violent crimes. If you look at the streets in general too, compared to West Oakland, if you go down the streets, they're wide open streets. Houses are not bunched up together. If you go down into some of these East Oakland neighborhoods, they're very close together. The streets are very narrow, and that causes problem when you try to throw so many people into a small area. If you look at all the studies that have been done, and one just came out yesterday, I think we're number 5 in the nation for crime. If you work 1 year in Oakland, it's like working a couple years in another department. Just our calls for service are greater than any other in the state. We average about 3,000-4,000 calls for service a day here in Oakland. We're concerned about homicides. It's always one of the things that we're always looking at because it is the most heinous crime that can be committed. The police are only out there, I mean, even though we're out there 24/7, there's only so much we can do. There's no rhyme or reason why homicides happen. If people want to, commit a homicide, they're going to get a gun, and they can commit a homicide. Can we deter that a little bit by having officers out there and maybe making arrests and taking people off the street, taking guns off the street? Yeah. But in the long run, if people want to kill somebody, they're going to be able to do it.
Pretty Black at a show one time. He was a youngster. He was an entertainer, you know? More than a hustler, he was an entertainer. He wasn't the best rapper out here, but he hustled through entertainment. He was living lavish, and I think a lot of people didn't like that. You feel me? He had it all, you know, at a young age, and some people out here, it's like a jealousy ring. When he came out the house, and his tires was on a flat. As soon as he got to the front gate, somebody, like, smacked him up. You know what I'm saying?
And you young niggas, man, really y'all best better stay in school. Because if I could do it again, all bullshit aside, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to be playing basketball, getting one of these $1 million checks. I ain't going to be out here risking my life every day doing the shit I'm doing. You feel me? So to the youngsters, man, if y'all going to do this gangster shit, be the best gangster you going to be. If you going to do the school shit, nigga, apply that shit to the best of your abilities, man. Because this street shit really ain't about nothing, man. You feel me? Niggas is dying out here in the streets, man. Niggas losing their lives every day. This shit real, nigga. So if you gonna play in this shit, just be ready to play it how it go, nigga. Cause, you know what I mean? Karma's a motherfucker.
Sick out here.
Last time you came out here, it been 3 people died, I think. 3 people we got on tape died. Oh yeah, just left us. And he was like, he about to go home, turn it in. He was like, bruh, let me get out the way for one of these dudes sideswipe my car or something. You feel me? These sideshow cats. Then like 15, I maybe 10 minutes later, I hear like 17 to 18 shots. I'm like, ooh, somebody just got it. Damn, somebody just got shot. I'm telling you, somebody just got shot. Next morning, I walk outside, go downstairs to the store. He like, you know they killed your boy in the purple car last night. I'm like, who? He like, your partner in the purple shell, Hennessy. Me, I didn't know that was my partner till the next day. And he died. That was a cool dude, though.
Hennessy was one of my friends I grew up with. He was like a couple years older than me, but I used to roam the neighborhood and always see him all the time. I got out the game, I started doing film, and he was like, man, I like that, man, I like you. I seen you transition in a couple years, man, I like that. The last words he told me was, man, I need that video. I had did a video with him in it, my cousin. And he was like, man, I need that video so I can show people what I'm in the videos, I'm doing more entertainment stuff than street stuff. When they transition over to some positive, all the bad and negative come back to you. I watched him change though. It like developed like that though. It was about to change, it was about to happen. He was more into his music, he was more into his kids and his life, you know what I'm saying? It was about to change. And when the change come, the storm come with that though.
That's it, nigga. That's about how I'm living, nigga. From the studio to the turf, back to the block, man. Live and direct, man. I took y'all to the streets of the East, man. Welcome to Oakland, California, you feel me? To the next episode, man. The saga continues, man. Peace out.
My name is Mona Hall. I'm here because of the violence in my life. I'm here because I gave birth to 3 children. And out of the 3, 2 of them was murdered. Jesse was murdered June 29th, 1992. Lil Bobby was murdered July 19th, 2008. For me, Bobby Hall II was a very sensitive, loving, caring baby. He was a young man who was 25, but he will forever be my baby. And when it comes to my children, Bobby or Jesse, some say they passed away. They didn't pass away, they were taken from us. He was murdered. Some coward snuck up, just like his older brother Jesse, and shot him in the back of the head. He never knew what had happened.
He shot him from behind, from the back of the head, through a window. He was sitting in an apartment, visiting one of his friends with his back to the window. And the fool came up to the window and shot through the window and hit Bobby in the back of the head. And if that ain't a coward, what is it?
In reality, it still don't seem real that some person as humble as Bobby will be mistaken for somebody else and have his brains blew out.
All my kids were close. You know, we spend time together. We have movie nights and all this kind of stuff. We really were a family, a tight family unit. This don't even feel like a home anymore. You know, I said it's filthy. I said, we worked all our lives to build something up for our family. To have somebody come in and tear it down. I said, it doesn't even feel like a home anymore. I gave birth to 3 children. I have 1 left.
I don't have no more brothers that could get killed. I only have cousins. And that bothered me. It's too late. Oh, and I'm just hecka frustrated right now. Because I shouldn't be having to sit up here and talk about somebody killing my brother, my little brother, or my big brother. People need to think before they kill people. You need to stop and evaluate stuff. Think about stuff. That is somebody's kid that you're doing this to. This is somebody's baby. This is somebody's uncle. This is somebody's, could be daddy, brother, cousin. Just stop and think about the people. It's just not that individual who you killing. You killing a whole family. You are killing and destroying a whole family when you take somebody's life. And there's no way that my kids and me should have to sit up. This, I'm so happy to say, this is what me and Bobby before. This is how happy we was together, being brother and sister. And then this is the end result. This is not a happy feeling. This is me and Bobby at Bobby's quiet hour. This hurt me. I don't want to look at this all the time, but I don't have no choice. I don't have no choice but to see my brother. This is the last time I seen him was laying up like this.
It's a scared feeling, but then, since I know that the person is out there, I'm mad, angry, and people shouldn't feel like this. They can say whatever, but this vengeance is like tearing me up in here.
I would tell all the young people, all the kids, right, because I got nieces and nephews too, and I tell them, right, think about what you would do. Think about how you felt when somebody in your family died. True, you might want to go retaliate, but leave it in God's hands. He say vengeance is his, so all you got to do is kick back and be patient. You know, if you don't got faith or you don't got no backbone in your spirituality, man, you ain't going to do it. You ain't going to last.
Wrongs to make a ghetto right where my real ones at. Put his face on a cotton, throw the hang on my back. Pour a little liquor where his body collapsed. Take a look around the hood, it's 50 niggas with straps. Before you know it, somebody else got clapped. I'm trying to get out,
but I feel like I'm trapped. You didn't kill one, you destroyed a whole family.
Gotta be
judged one day, how you think God gon' handle it? It's East Oakland and it's taking me over. Face the aces of jokers, I ride with a toaster.
Watch him throw it all away.
The kids, the wife, for San Quentin bus and 25 to life.
These youngsters living for strikes
in that ghetto hype. Out here we rock blue jeans, white tees and nights. It's just East Oakland and it's taking us over.
I don't like to say that it ain't hope, because that's not good to say. It's being pessimistic. That means being negative. But unless everybody come together and raise their kids right, which is probably not gonna happen, you know, it ain't no hope. Because you can't keep talking to nobody. Like, I'm talking on this tape or this on the camera right now, but it's gonna reach people who want it to reach them. But it really ain't gonna do nothing as far as, you know, it's just words. It's words that go in one ear and out the other.
In all these cases, did they ever catch the killer?
No. No, they didn't catch the killers. None of the killers has been caught. None of them have been caught in the 3 cases that I know of. My friends have. No killers have been caught. Nobody have came forward. Nobody has told. Nobody has said nothing. I just want to know why. What made you just walk up like, I'm about to kill Pretty Black today or tonight? Or what made you be like, Hennessy gonna die?
So I try and leave the street shit alone as much as I can, because it ain't pretty. It's not fun. It's not amusing to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's actually sad. You know what I'm saying? Because everything about the streets, in the end, it ain't never a happy ending. It's always somebody dying or somebody going to jail for a long time. You don't get to see no. It's always a tragic ending.
Man, it's like, sometimes it's like a dream, you know? Sometimes I be feeling like they just locked up somewhere, or they went on vacation and they gonna call one day, but it's not though, it's real.
You can't stop nothing, it ain't gonna stop. It ain't gonna stop, but it's hope for a certain few. And mm-hmm. hopefully if you could get that certain few and that select few and put them together in some sort of community and start them to going, then that's the hope right there. You know, I never really been nowhere, but hopefully with the music avenue I'm going through, I'll be able to get out and make a better living for my family and my people that's around me.
You gotta just keep moving, because if you stop, then you're gonna start thinking about a whole bunch of stuff, and the cycle just gonna eat you up. My thing is to move out of this place, get my family out of Oakland, and stay healthy. That's it. You know what I'm saying? That's all I pray for, just to get wealthy and healthy.
Weapon was found nearby. Police say it appears there was a gunfight at some point.